VHF were able to give me the sort of information that nobody else could have given me.
In effect, the British Heart Foundation have saved my life because of the research they've done and are continuing to do now.
VHF actually provide that aftercare that we depend on so much.
More discoveries and more material advances are made here because we have a strong and important charity like the VHF.
It's invaluable. I'd gone into hospital to have my second child. It was decided that I needed an emergency cesarean section. And as soon as I was injected, my heart stopped. Once the baby was out and safe, they resuscitated me. I was diagnosed as having cardiomyopathy. There are no symptoms with cardiomyopathy. It's just a congenitive heart disorder.
The British Heart Foundation funds really all aspects of cardiovascular research, heart and blood vessel research. So we study individuals to look at their DNA, to look at their genes, to try to understand why some people have a certain form of heart disease and why others don't. There are many VHF-funded labs like this across the UK. Really, this funding underpins pretty much most of what we do, and without it, we wouldn't be able to conduct diagnosis and prevention and treatment of heart disease.
I take two kinds of medication daily. The very fact that I only have to take two small pills to keep me alive is absolutely brilliant. Because of the work of the British Heart Foundation and the research that they carry out, it's given me hope to live a full and active life.
Without you, we couldn't have made life-saving medical advances.
I'd just been in the gym when I started to feel very dull ache around my shoulders and neck, and I started to get breathless. Pain started becoming much more intense. It dawned on me that this must be what it's like to be having a heart attack. When the ambulance arrived, they delivered shock therapy with an external defibrillator. That got my pulse back again. Without you, I wouldn't be here. Just before I was discharged, the nurses gave me a pack with lots of booklets from the VHF, and that helped me learn about my illness and how to manage it. But I also rung the VHF 24-hour helpline. That's more than actually just give you information. They reassure you. It was a source of information that you wouldn't find anywhere else, and they in turn referred me to the heart failure nurses. The support I had from them was absolutely invaluable.
It's massively important that we build up a trusting relationship with our patients and with the families as well. Have you had any chest pain? It's nice for the patients to have a specifically named nurse that knows them well, that knows the whole history and has seen them on a regular basis. The aim really is to empower the patient so that they're able to manage their own condition. The ongoing support and funding that we get from the VHF is massively important. You're right.
Yeah. The heart failure nurse was actually critical to helping me move on and actually get better.
Without you, we couldn't continue to offer specialist help and support.
I took part in the London to Brighton bike ride for the British Heart Foundation. I felt an amazing sense of achievement for like 2 weeks afterwards, and even now when I think about it, I'm really glad that I did it and raised so much money for the British Heart Foundation. I rode the London to Brighton bike ride primarily because of my granddad. He actually died from a heart condition when he was 47, and I just thought it was something extra than putting a bunch of flowers on a grave. My granddad's condition is actually hereditary. It's high cholesterol, so now I constantly have mine checked every 6 months religiously. With the support of the British Heart Foundation, I'm quite lucky that I would be okay. When I crossed the finish line and rode down Brighton Pier, I felt like I could do anything, like I could achieve anything that I wanted to. Without you, I wouldn't have had this rewarding experience.
with your help,
we can continue this vital work.